Hey guys, what's up? It's Ivana Estelle. I like to say I'm Ivana Estelle because I feel like I'm speaking in third person when I say it's Ivana Estelle. Anyway, welcome back to my channel. Today, I am going to show you how to create an If I Go Missing file. What is that you say? It is a file literally for should something happen to you or if you got missing. How people can pick up little clues and pieces to figure out what the fuck to do to either find you or help you. Not even either, to find you and to help you. I got this idea from Ashley Flowers and Britt. They are two podcasters from the podcast Crime Junkies, which is my favorite podcast. And then True Crime Obsessed, and then Cold, and then Joe Exotic, and then To Live and Die in LA. So this is actually very important. I made my If I Go Missing file probably about 2 years ago. I was living in DC, Maryland by myself. I still am. And my immediate family lives in New Jersey. I'm kind of a deadbeat cousin, so the cousins and aunts and uncles that I do have in Maryland, I don't really hang out with that much. So I realized it's really important for me to make this fucking file. So what is my If I Go Missing file? Like I said, it's a file for if you go missing, clues that really best describe you. I start out with a couple of things. One, your social security number and bank account information. This is just so people can literally know exactly who you are and verify who you are. It's also bank account information, logging in online and to be able to access it, maybe print out. The reason that you should have these things is because your family needs to kind of trace the last kind of movements that you've made. If you were buying certain things, if you weren't buying certain things, they need to be able to kind of pick up those pieces and kind of see if anything was going off. If you haven't spent money in like a couple weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, something is kind of concerning and should be looked into. If you start buying really strange things and it's not coming up as fraud because maybe someone has your credit card, it's time to start looking in on it. The next thing I gave them is my social media information. I have my Instagram. I don't have Facebook because Facebook sucks. I have my Gmail account, my work email, my Twitter, my podcast. I don't have a podcast. My YouTube video channel. I have also my blog, how to log into that. It's just different ways to sign in and kind of interact and see what's been going on into my social media, as well as, and you can blame this on Big Brother, all those apps and websites, they use cookies to track where you've been and where you could possibly be going or where your last movements were. So to be able to log into that, especially for Google and Gmail, we can kind of see without having to wait for the police to get actual allowance to have access to that information. People can sign in themselves and kind of see where your last movements are. It's really important to have it, especially if your phone is suddenly turned off. The third thing is I let them know that there are specific parts of my body that you cannot miss. For example, I always wear these necklaces. If you don't see me with this necklace on or see someone with this necklace that looks like me or I don't know, anything suspicious with these necklaces, you know that something is up. I always have them. It's like my signature piece. Also tattoos. I used to have one. Now I have three. My parents, if they read the If I Go Missing file, know about the third. They definitely don't know about it in person because I did not tell them because it was kind of on a whim. But it's just signature stamps that describe myself should something bad happen to me and could be easy to help identify. I always say to myself, if something, God forbid, were to happen and I wasn't able to protect myself, I would take one of my necklaces and I would rip it off and throw it. Hopefully, somehow, someone that been seeing my last movements, and when they search the area, they would be able to find it. The next thing to have on there are people that you communicate with in person. So I have about 10 to 15 people in DC/Maryland/Virginia that I hang out with all the time. I have their names and I have their phone numbers. I also have a list of people that I can't communicate with and I'm in contact with constantly. So I have my three best friends on there. I have the guy that I'm dating on there. I have just people that I communicate with. The next thing I have are my list of family, and I listed in order people that would notice something bad happened to me first. It's no shade. I'm pretty sure it would probably go my dad, then it would go my sister Elise, then it would go my mom, and then it would go my sister Liana. So I have their information there as well and in order, just kind of to who you probably should be in contact with or who will probably contact the police first. Last but not least, I have run-ins with any mother. Please beep that out. any freak or bastard or asshole that I had a run-in with, whether that was 5 years ago, 2 years ago, 30 minutes ago, right before I started filming this video, their names and that run-in is written down. I have, of course, from like the crazy guy I went on a date with to like the time I decided to act out and got jumped when I was 20 years old 5 years ago. I have a crazy boyfriend and a crazy ex-girlfriend on there. Like, I have people that I have had run-ins with. So, because most times when something violent happens, it's against an assailant that you know. Of course, there are times where the person does not know who this person is that's attacking them, but you get those people that think you know out the way first, those suspects first. Last but not least, I have my relationship status. Nothing says, what are we like? What should I put in my FICO missing file? No, seriously, you need to put it in. Who are you dating? Who are you romantically involved with? Especially women of color. Women of color, 9 out of 10 times, know the person that is ending up violating them, whether it is the person that has murdered them or has violently attacked them. That's not to say that not like every woman, but it is a very higher risk for women of color. So it is really important to have that on there. Last but not least, because I keep saying that, a picture of yourself. Every time I go onto social media and someone goes missing, they have like a picture of these people that are missing, and they have like some sort of fucking filter over there. Why are there 3 hearts over and like eyes that are like 3 times too big and a skin complexion that's 3 times lighter than them? It doesn't look like that person. I picked out 2 photos that actually really resemble me. Genuinely, like, no matter what I did to myself, you could tell that this is my face. It's a selfie with my hair pulled back and another picture of me standing up, which has my body shape. Not the body shape of me when I was 16 years old and a twig, my normal body shape right now. So I have all that on there, and they can use those pictures to send them around to through social media and give them to the police as well. Anyway, like I said, all this stuff is kind of scary. I know it puts you on edge. What I ended up doing was creating this file, and I sent it to my immediate family and also my 3 best friends. If you have a best friend that you guys just became cool like 2 months ago, I don't worry. I'm not judging. I get it. I have that. But I'm not sending it to that girl. Why? Because I'm going to send it to people that really, really, really know me. All 3 of my best friends, I've been friends with them for at minimum 5 years. And of course, my family have known me for 25 years. So they are the ones that are going to get that information. And I sent it in an encrypted file so that no one else can get it, because obviously my social's in there and my bank account information. I don't want to get motherfucking defrauded while I'm trying to save my own life. Anyway, like I said, get this information. It takes about 15 minutes literally to create the file. Create it, send it, just keep that peace of mind. Of course, I don't even know how to do YouTube videos. Please put also places that you frequent. So for me, it's this one hookah lounge called Amsterdam. It's a grocery store and it's my apartment. Throw that in there as well. I'm going to list in the bio below all the items that I put in the If I Go Missing file. I really, really hope that you and encourage you to do this. It doesn't take that much time. We're literally on a quarantine. You have nothing else to do. So just make the freaking file. You'll feel better and your loved ones will feel better too. As always, like, comment, subscribe, tell me what you think, tell me how it was making your file, and thank you for taking the time to listen and watch this video. Have a wonderful day. If it's gloomy outside, because it's gloomy where I am right now, then make the file after you click out of this, and then go watch some movies.